nation. The gospel can change any country. The gospel can change any family. It can change your spouse. The gospel of Jesus that turned Saul to a Paul, that made a harlot Mary Magdalene to becoming an evangelist. When the gospel is preached with power, signs and wonders, and is embraced, it has the capacity to change a sinner to a saint. There is power enough in this house to bring deliverance to every one of you afflicted.
Any pit where there is for you. Any pit where there is for you. Any pit where there is for you. When I know your mama digambo. When I know your brother digambo. When I know your director digambo. Your teacher digamo, anybody when he digamo, they go fall inside the pit, then go soul into the pit. They go they jump and jump and jump, hey. Jump, 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 jump.
Don't understand, we are going somewhere. Every one of you must have something new to talk about. You might be seated, sit down, cross your leg and say, welcome to day three, never again. That's a sign of life. That's a sign of victory. Let the people praise him. Let the people praise him. Even so shall the earth yield her increase. If the earth will yield her increase, your mouth must be opened and bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Miracles everywhere. First day was great. Second day was much more greater. And this is the third day. The Bible said Jesus was in the grave the third day. The grave could not contain him. Never again. Nambahadi karada bash keteba. If you have not sweated, sweat. But it's the last sweat you will sweat this year. Our fathers erected strange altars in pursuit of their comfort and that of future generations without considering the consequences of such altars. They did that with good intentions. They did that without having to think the aftermath of their actions or decisions. And hence, a lot of people fall victims of what our forefathers did. If they were just to suffer the consequences alone, it were a different case. But even after they must have died many years, the suffering still continues until this day. We have the audacity to shout it on top of our voices, never again. I will not suffer for what I don't know about. I didn't hear that. I will not suffer for what I don't know about. But it was a singular act of Abraham's obedience of faith that turned things around for us. Galatians 3:13 said, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For curse is anyone hung on a tree that the blessing of Abraham might rub off on you. Never again, first mentioned in Genesis 8, like I did share with you yesterday, when Noah erected that altar and put a sacrifice until God smelled that sacrifice and said, never again will I destroy the earth with waters. And that was a sign of a rainbow. I prophesy today, from this day forward, your lives will be colorful. What used to stop you will no longer stop you. Those who have denied you help, I declare that tonight, God will touch them for you. Every door of help that had been shut up against you, if your amen is the loudest, I command them open now. They will not meet you where they left you. Zephaniah chapter 3. Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 14. Sing, O daughter of Zion. You can now see why we needed to sing, to prepare the atmosphere for God to take over every situation in our lives. You see, when you verbalize, then God releases angels to God mobilizes his angels to bring to pass the immutability of his counsel. He says, sing, O daughter of Zion. Even when it doesn't look right, doesn't seem convenient for you, he says, sing. When you sing, you feed God with his food, offering unto God the sacrifice of your praise. Paul and Silas in Acts 16 began to praise God when it was not convenient for them, and God stepped in. Let me tell you this, friends. When you pray, there might be tendencies for delays. But when you praise, God comes down himself to answer to you. Daniel prayed and it took 21 days for the parcel to reach to where he was. But anytime you praise God, he comes down and inhabits the praise of his people. Sing, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O Israel. I don't know if someone has got some mouth there that wants to practice what blind Bartimaeus practice and gather some momentums and shout it. That shout was the shout of never again. He was blind all his life until he made up his mind, never again will he be blind, by using what he had to have what he did not have. If you capitalize on the things you don't have, you will never move on. Blind Bartimaeus realized that Jesus was passing by and he said, who is that? They said, Jesus. So he said, anyways, I don't want to be collecting sympathies and sorries. No amount of sorry can change your situation. So what did he do? He said, I'm only blind, I'm not dumb. I'm only blind, I'm not lame. I'm only blind, I'm not insane. I will use what I have to get what I don't have. You can't be left with nothing. But if you want people to always want to say sorry to you, friends, you will die on top of that situation. Make up your mind. It's not the worst times ever lived. My future is much more glorious than my present. He said, I'm only blind, but I can hear. And faith does not come by what you see, faith comes by what you hear. I have a good network, it's working for me. I'm not crippled. The first law of open doors is motion. Until you move, nothing moves. Friends, miracles are bound to happen, but you have to put in your faith mechanisms to receive it. You receive faith by hearing, you release faith by speaking. So if you don't like what you see, change what you say. Say it consistently until things change. Words are spiritual. The words I speak to you, they are spirit and they are life. There are people here within the next 72 hours, and I'm saying this convincingly. The places where help has been shut up against you. If your amen is resounding, that help will come to you. You see, I said that help will come to you. But he made sure he was not going to shout the wrong direction, the wrong place. Many seek for help from the wrong source, wrong places, so it compounds their problem. My brother had the Satrole Brakatama Sambaya. Thou son of David, have mercy on me. What does that mean? Mercy is a prevailing force. Number two, mercy suspends judgment. Any satanic judgment upon you, embargoes upon your finances, your marital status, your academics, your career, every embargo over you, by the blood of Jesus, if your amen is allowed, they are lifted. They are lifted. There are three kinds of embargo. One, oral embargo. Spoken embargoes. Embargoes are spiritual words released by those higher in authority over you to put a limitation to your lives or an impediment. They are spiritual barricades orchestrated by words. Somebody above you speaks negative words over you. Like Balaam employs a prophet to come and curse God's people. There are those. Now you don't have to do them some wrong for them to hate you. That you are alive is enough for them to hate you. That you are successful is enough. That they don't even know what's happening to you is enough to hate you. Some don't know what makes you think, and they should not know what makes you think. Employed a prophet. He said, come and curse Israel for me. Not knowing Zion has sung. Not knowing Zion has shouted. Not knowing that Zion is carrying a blessing. You cannot curse whom God has blessed. I don't know who I'm talking to here. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3. Blessed be God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who had blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. Touch your forehead and say, I'm blessed. Amen. Let the devil be mad about your blessing. Say, I'm blessed. Amen. Let the devil hear you say, I'm blessed. Amen. Come and curse God's people. Now, it's a bad market for anyone who goes anywhere to place a curse on you. Yes, sir. Every embargo that has come over you by words that have limited your finances, limited your breakthroughs, I command those embargoes lifted. Now, they are not only lifted, hear me, ladies and gentlemen, I send them back to the senders. Come and curse God's people for me. That's the place of sacrifice. He raised seven altars and put sacrifices on these altars. The negative supernatural understands sacrifice than even the positive supernatural. And then raised seven altars and put sacrifices on that to empower his words. Altar is a place of traffic where humanity meets with divinity. Altar is a place where sacrifices are made unto deities. You don't beg deities, you appease deities. Altar is a place. Now, the strength of any altar is the sacrifice on that altar. So if you are binding the devil on with an empty altar, you know what you're doing? It's like pointing a toy gun to an armed robber, and after a while he now discovers it's a toy gun. You're done. The strength of any altar is the sacrifice. So he raised seven altars and put sacrifices just to curse. The enemies have enough time for you. So you have enough time for God. You belittle yourselves when you come narrowing yourself before the enemy, no? Have enough time for God like you have in here. Look at you, thousands of you coming to worship God. Raise the altar and put sacrifices on his way to trying to curse God's people. He met with his Waterloo. He met with bad markets. Tell your neighbor, I'm a bad market. I don't like what you say. Say, neighbor, I am a bad market. My blood is bitter. And as he was going to go curse God's people, he met with a restriction. He said, no, you can't curse these ones. They're already blessed. God's blessed them, and you can't do otherwise. He tried it again, and God warned him for the last time. If you don't want to lose your life, stop there. Now I prophesy. Whoever goes to any house, any altar, trying to curse you, I command that curse to return back to die. Lift a voice and say, my Father, in the name of Jesus, every negative words spoken over my life that is working against me, back to sender, back fire by fire, lift a voice and fire. Sit down. I feel an anointing here. Yeah. These are embargoes, oral embargoes. Somebody says it no go better for you. Don't keep quiet. You will say it don't better for me already. I'm not alone. I am with God. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. And every tongue that rises against me in judgment I condemn. It better for me, because when Jesus came, he died. He did not only die, he went to the cross and died, and then he was buried, and on the third day you could not stop him. If you could not stop him, you cannot stop me. You cannot stop my marriage. You cannot stop my ministry. You cannot stop my business. You cannot stop my children. Am I talking to somebody here? Say to your neighbor, say, neighbor, I am unstoppable. The shout of the king is in the midst of them. Lalabaya Sakabaya. He says, sing, O daughter of Zion, and shout, O Israel. Can you see the connectivity? Can you see the interwovenness? You begin by singing and graduate into shouting. There's nothing wrong when you shout. There's nothing wrong when you sing. There's nothing wrong when you jump. For the Lord has turned your captivity around. I'm shouting because I can see the handwriting on the walls of Jericho. I have been quiet enough. I passed through the walls the first day, the second day. They thought I was a fool. Silence is golden. When I was passing through, I was silent because the Bible said, be still and know that I am God. Hear this closely. Hear this closely. I went through the walls of Jericho, and I became unassuming. They never knew I was gathering some potentials, some momentums. The first day, second day, third day, fourth, fifth, fifth, sixth, the seventh day, I received an instruction. Now, shout.
Some of you, for your miracles to come, you got to shout. For your breakthroughs to come, you got to shout. For your deliverance to come, you got to shout. Clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God with a voice, hey, of triumph.
Hear this.
Look to your neighbor, say, neighbor. Not there yet. Say, neighbor. Hey!
Now that exclamation is an arrow to the kingdom of darkness. Are you ready for that? Say, neighbor. Hey! For the last time, you can shut down sickness, shut down the powers of darkness, shut down witches and wizards, shut down failure, shut down disappointments, shut down your delays, shut down your fears. There's something in your mouth. Ah! Let the people praise him. Even so, shout it. Yeah, I increase.
Watch. Hey.
Have you got some mouth? I don't care what you are passing through. You can shout your way out of the trouble. You can shout your way out of death. You can shout, for the Lord has given you the victory. Now hear this. The seventh day, when he asked them to shout, the walls were still standing. The blind is still blind. The cripple is still crippled. The lame is still lame. The deaf is still deaf. The dumb is still dumb. The brokenhearted is still brokenhearted. The indebted is still indebted. The walls of Jericho were still erected, yet he said, shout. Now, watch. It was easier to shout after the collapse, not before the collapse. It was easier to sing after the job, not before the job. After the breakthrough, not before the breakthrough. It was easier to shout after that you have gotten promoted, not when you are still under promoted. The walls of Jericho were still erected up. But it says, the act of faith is to say it, to see it. Blessed is she that believeth, for there shall be a performance. Maria Galataba. Watch. I don't care your condition. This is the requirement. Act faith. Live. The just shall live by his own faith. So when one is shouting, others are not shouting, leave them alone. Now you know what they do. Make you not take your own, stop your own.
Oracle!
Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. When he asked them to shout, there was no sign of collapse. You don't have to see the wind. You don't have to see no sign, no rain, but the valley will be filled. The new week you catch, the alert will hit your accounts. Hear this? The degree of your shouting determines the force of the collapse of the walls of Jericho. Let me hear you say, neighbor! I got it. Now let's go on. Sit down. Now, I want to say something to those who are smart in the spirit. The first 100 people that will jump up and shout Jesus. No, sit down. Sit down. I will say it. One, now you are over 5,000 people here. But I'm looking for 100 people. If you can read my lips and you jump up first, as soon as I shout Jesus, then believe me, I bet you with my 10 fingers and my 10 toes, in the next 72 hours, what you have been looking for will turn around looking for you. So be careful when I will call Jesus. No man knoweth the day nor the hour. Jesus! No. Too bad. Sit down. La bola hadaba laga de lege baraga. Ebahada.
Rama karabosere kuro limbrosi. Limbrosi kentra morse karaba.
Namola.
La brose kentra.
Namola.
Lere mosi.
I am in the midst of you. I have come with my judgmental hands. I will undo all those that afflicted you, said the Spirit of the Lord. Shout yes. Now, let's go on. Remember the word Jesus, the name Jesus. He that sleepeth no more. How many were wise virgins? How many were foolish virgins? So we want to know how many thousands are foolish or wise here tonight. Sing, O daughters of Zion. Shout, O Israel. Be glad and rejoice with all your heart. O daughter of Jerusalem. With all your heart, not part of your heart. Now, verse 15. The Lord hath taken away thy judgments. Is that in your Bible? Every satanic judgment over your health, your career, the Lord had taken them away. Yeah. Satanic judgments are impediments. Like I said to you, there are oral embargoes and there are written embargoes.
We hope you've been really blessed by this message from Bishop Isaac Idahosa. For more inquiries and audiovisual messages, please call. May the Word of God enrich your soul as you continue to listen to our messages. Stay connected to God, because every day is a blessing. Thank you and God bless you.